In this clip, we'll present how to create a new floor surface material by importing an AeroWay texture. Let's see how to create such an amazing surface material as this wood floor. To achieve this level of realism, we will use a carefully prepared texture library that contains ultra-high definition images. There are a few companies that specialize in creating textures of this quality, so for a great example, we'll pick one made by AeroWay. The dimension of these images usually varies between 6 and 10,000 pixels. Such a high resolution enables us to put the camera close to the particular surface and still have a sharp, detailed render image. When using procedural materials, the result is never as satisfying as with image-based surface materials. Now let's see how to use these textures. First, we'll give the name to the surface material by a naming method that will help us identify it easily in the future when using hundreds of other materials from the same library. AW stands for the name of the company, AeroWay. Wood flooring refers to the material and its usage type. 028 is the image number from the catalog. And 4x4 meters is the real-life dimension of the surface material. By having the CineRender engine in ARCHICAD, we will learn some new logic for configuring a surface material. Think of the list on the left side as layers that are put on top of each other. Each of these are so-called channels that add a particular kind of touch to the surface material and change its look. The color channel is the base of almost every material. This is where we will put the texture that ends with the letter D. D refers to the diffuse. In other render engines, when there's no color channel, we use this image in the diffuse channel. In CineRender, however, the diffuse texture of AeroWay libraries usually goes to the color channel. We can load the image directly under the color channel. But first, we will create a filter. And as the final step, add the image into the filter. Later, we'll come back to this and explain why we did it this way. Let's have a quick look at what our surface material looks like with the actual settings. As rendering takes some time, we'll come back when the rendering is finished. The floor is completely matte now. Let's give it some highlights. For this, we are using the following settings in the specular channel. Let's render the scene again. Now the floor has an overall smooth highlight, but that's not what we're looking for. What we want is to have only certain parts of the floor highlighted and other parts to not be highlighted. To achieve this, we'll use a mat or a mask in the specular channel. To have a better understanding of how a mask works, let's take a look at this surface material. It has a medium gray in the color channel, and the specular channel is also turned on. We add a checkerboard shader into the specular channel. Where the checkerboard is black, the surface material has no highlight. Where it's white, there is a highlight. So the black and white values of any image or shader will define which part of the surface material will be highlighted and which part will not. Let's put the image ending with R into the specular channel. Change the width and height values to 70 and 100. And render the scene again. The floor looks quite interesting, like it's been used for some time, but it's not what we want. Our room should have a newly made lacquered wood floor. As a next step, we will add the file ending with the letter R to the reflection channel. Again, a low brightness value of 20% will result in a fine but not too strong reflection. Let's render our scene and see how we're progressing. Well, what we have here is quite interesting. Thanks to the image we used, some regions have a weak reflection, but most of the surface is reflecting the color of the walls too intensively, almost like a mirror. What we forgot to do is to change the mix mode to multiply. Let's correct this mistake and render the scene again. Okay, it's much better now, but it still looks shabby. Turning off the specular channel will solve our problem. Let's make sure we are right and render it again. The reflection is obviously too sharp. A wood floor would never look like a mirror. Adding some blurriness will solve this problem and result in a nice dispersed reflection. Please note, the higher value of blurriness you use, the higher your render time will be. Therefore, try to keep this value as low as possible. The render is finished, and as you can see on the right image, the value of 20% blurriness in reflection made the wood floor quite promising. The next thing we're missing is the use of the bump channel. The geometry of the floor is a perfectly flat surface. At the same time, the flooring is never even. Here and there, the floor has irregularities. And also, the structure of the wood itself is never perfectly flat, even when it's lacquered. The bump channel will help give us the illusion of these irregularities, the tiny relief details, without the need to modify the geometry of the slab element. We put the image with the file name ending with the letter B into the bump channel, as B refers to bump. A strength value of 20% will suit our needs. But first, let's render the scene with bump turned off completely, and render only a small part of the scene using the Marquee tool. As you can see, the camera icon has changed, indicating that it will render only the selected part. There are also further options to choose from in the pop-up menu. Let's render the scene again with a bump value of 2000. And again with 20%. As we can see, a high value of 2000 not only makes the wood look raw, but completely destroys our reflections. The value of 20% gives a nice touch to the wood. Please note the difference in these regions. The result of bump should never be too aggressive, so try to keep the effective bump channel as subtle as possible. One more thing. For fine-tuning the bump value, always render your scene with the camera that is close to the surface. We are satisfied with our wood floor material and ready to use it outside of the test scene. As a final step, let's delete the image from the specular channel to tidy things up. In addition, we'll create another version of this wood floor surface with a slightly different color. To achieve this, let's duplicate the surface material. I'm sure you remember the filter that we started with. All the settings here are the default values. We want a slightly more reddish floor. For this, we set the hue value to 350 degrees. If you want, you can also change the brightness and other properties with these sliders. Let's render our scene using this modified wood. We've made two great-looking wood floor materials ready for action. Please note, the settings introduced are just one way to set up a wood floor material, and is in no way an official recommendation from Arroway or Graphisoft. For every image-based surface material, you will have to use different settings in order to bring out the best and to match your particular needs. As always, when making a surface material on our own, please make sure to use a proper test scene that's capable of revealing the true nature of a particular material. Please watch our other video clip explaining the importance of a test scene. Please remember, for your own needs, you can download the PLN containing the indoor scene presented from the Graphisoft websites.